Hi guys, welcome back to Cardz TV. This is Mary, and I told you a few videos back that the Close to My Heart catalog was out, and this has got so many awesome things in it, guys. Oh my goodness. I have been looking at this. It's like every night after dinner, it's like my novel. I sit down with this catalog, and I plan what I'm going to order and what I'm going to make out of all these awesome things that are in this catalog. Now, guys, go over and check with Linda, and I think if you place an order with her, you will get a free catalog. So be sure and do that. I'm going to leave you a link down below this video on my blog as well as on YouTube. This is one of my favorite things from this collection called Craft On. This is a stamp set that also comes with thin cuts dies. Oh my. We've got these pretty little flowers. We've got a pinwheel. We've got a little heart with cross stitching in it. This adorable spool of thread with a needle. And for sentiments, we've got made with love and a little glitter. How cute is that? You mean the world to me. Oh, and there's a little heart. Thanks, friend. So what's new? And create a little sunshine. We're going to use this for today's card. And part of the collection is a paper pack, a pack of coordinating cardstock, and there's also a workshop your way called Craft On for making cards. And I'll show you this one in another video. But today we're going to use this adorable blue and white striped paper. And I don't know if you can see it, but the blue has little stitches running through it. And there's two of each one of these papers in this paper pack, and they're all double-sided. And look at this side. Oh my gosh. I'm in love with this paper. It's so cute. Love the flowers. And you can see they match the flowers in the stamp set. So this is just one of the papers in this paper pack. And you can check all these out over at the Close to My Heart site. Just go to Linda's site and you can see all of them. And the little zip strips at the top are so much fun. This one has lots of little buttons on it. Oh, so cute. For today's card, I decided to use this little spool of thread with the needle and the thread coming off of it. So I took some Memento Rich Cocoa ink and I went ahead and stamped it. And we're going to go ahead and get this cut out. These plates are just about broken on my Big Shot. And I'm going to take the die off that matches this little spool. And these come on a nice little magnetic sheet. I've got a magnetic plate under here. But I'm going to go ahead and, let's see, we'll get this on just right. I'm going to go ahead and use some tape to hold that down to make sure it does not move. And I'm going to get this run through the Big Shot. Let's take a look and see what we've got here. Pull that tape off carefully. How cute. For our card today, I grabbed a white card base. This is 4.25 by 5.5. It's a side folding card, and I decided to use Cardz TV Card Kit and Caboodle sketch number 8, and you can get all these sketches over at my blog, cardztv.blogspot.com. They're free to download, guys. I think I've got 29 now. Number 30's coming soon. Now, if we look at the sketch, this is our card base, as I said, 4.25 by 5.5. Now, the next mat, it says it's 4 by 5.25, but I like to put just a solid mat behind my pattern paper. So I cut this red mat at 4 1/8 by 5 3/8. That's going to go down first. And then my 4 by 5.25 mat is going to go on top of that. And I love this blue and white stripe Next on the sketch, we see we have a border that's 1.5 inches by 5.25 inches. So I cut the reverse side of that blue and white stripe, and that's that pretty little flowered border. And the next border is 1/2 inch by 5.25 inches. And this is the zip strip off of one of the other papers that comes in that pack. And I really like putting black and white gingham with other prints. I think it adds a lot of interest. So that's going to go right there. I just love the colors and the patterns in this paper pack. So pretty together. Now, if we look over here at the sketch, we see we have two rectangles. We have one 2.25 by 3 inches and another 2.5 by 3.25 inches. So I cut the 2.5 by 3.25 out of some more of that red, and then I cut a white one to go on top of that at the 2.25 by 3 inch measurement. I'm going to get these attached together. This is going to go right there. And I went ahead and stamped it with So What's New from that cute little stamp set. And I used Memento Tuxedo Black ink. And then we're going to take that cute little spool of thread that I stamped and cut out. And I took a blue marker and I tried to match the blue of the stripe and went over the string on the spool just to help it all come together. Okay, I've got this popped up on some foam tape for some extra dimension, and I thought it needed just a little bit more red. So I grabbed the little heart die that comes in this set, and I cut out some little hearts, and we're going to add some to the front, and we're just going to, if I can pick them up, we're going to add some to the front, just give it a little bit more interest. And just another little pop of red. And we'll just put these down with the art glitter glue. I think we need one right there. I've cut out three, so we'll see if we need all three or if two will work. And another one right there. And there we have it, guys. A cute little card made with the Close to My Heart Craft On paper kit and stamp and thin cut set. Now guys, you can go and pick up any of these Close to My Heart supplies from my sweet friend Linda. I'll leave her link right down here below this video on YouTube as well as my blog. Thank you so very much for coming by today, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this. I've sure had fun doing this. Hope you did too. And I will see you again soon with another card. Bye now.